right now. We are being joined by Professor Larry Gibson. Professor Gibson, as we all know, his political background in this area, everybody from Mayor Kurt Schmoke to President Bill Clinton to Governor Paris Glendening, you name the campaigns, he's been involved with them. We saw him at the podium with Kweisi and Mfume upon his announcement that he was running for Congress. So first of all, good morning, Professor Larry Gibson.
Good morning. Good morning, C4.
Look, I got reached out to you by individuals surrounding the Kweisi and Mfume campaign because they said that you would like to direct comments toward Dr. Maya Rockeymoore Cummings' statement, Professor Gibson.
Yes, I'm hurt. I mean, it's hurtful to be falsely accused of such insensitive conduct as she alleges in the Morning Sun. In the Morning Sun, she states, a quote, this is an actual quote, quote, less than 36 hours after my husband passed, he, speaking of Kweisi Mfume, and Larry Gibson asked for a meeting through my pastor. Then that's the end of the quote. Then she said, we scheduled a meeting. It didn't happen. I did text him, and I didn't get a response. Those statements are false, and I'm just hurt by them. Elijah died on the 17th. His funerals were held the next week, so he's like that on Monday or Tuesday, on that Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. The following Sunday, that's now 10 days after Elijah's death, I do know that Kweisi called her pastor and said, I don't know what Maya intentions are with respect to this seat. Can we find out? And he proposed a meeting in which we could get together. It would be her pastor, myself, Elijah, and her, because Elijah had never mentioned to her, to me, any prospect of her replacing him. And he and I talked about just about everything. I'd never heard that. So we wanted to see what did she want to do. And a meeting was scheduled for the 28th. Now this 11 days after his death at my house, scheduled precisely at 6:30, and 3 hours. It was going to be Kweisi, Dr. Thomas, Elijah's pastor, Meyer, and myself. 3 hours before, she called and said that she was feeling exhausted and didn't, you know, wanted to cancel the meeting and she'd get back in touch with. This is like 11 days after his death. So this statement about 36 hours, I mean, that would have been ridiculously insensitive. And I'm just hurt that she would make such an accusation. It is categorically not true.
Professor Gibson, exactly if I might give reference, mm-hmm. because now that I know what you're referencing, is a Baltimore Sun article, ladies and gentlemen, written by Luke Broadwater, which talks about three people close to Congressman Cummings running against each other for his seat. It includes Mr. Harry Spikes, who was actually a speaker also, and everybody knows how close he was to Congressman Cummings at the service, former Congressman Kweisi Mfume, and Dr. Cummings herself. And what you're referencing, Professor Larry Gibson, longtime professor of law at University of Maryland Law School, is the comment quoted here in the paper, less than 36 hours after my husband passed, he and political strategist Larry Gibson asked for a meeting through my pastor. We scheduled a meeting. It didn't happen. I did text him, and I didn't get a response. That's what you are referencing.
I'm saying that did not happen. 10 days after his passing, Kweisi called her pastor and says, I'm considering running, but I don't know whether Maya is. Can we have a meeting and discuss this, how we all might proceed? One option I know that at that point Kweisi was considering was just running for the remainder of the term. And then, you know, the special election.
Sure.
But no one knew what she intended to do. A meeting was scheduled for now would have been the 11th day, not 36 hours. And no one contacted her within 36 hours about anything except for a funeral. She called me and said Elijah requested that I speak at the funeral. That's the only discussion that I had with her soon after his election, that she said, you know, would I speak at the funeral? That was Elijah's intention. So this thing about this suggestion that, I mean, just how insensitive that would have been. That what she says in the paper here today is categorically untrue, is false. It's not even close to a reality.
Professor Gibson, let me ask you this. Let me ask you this, Professor Gibson. Let me ask you this because it's important for our audience to place this, you know, and understand what's going on. So in terms of your being hurt, I can understand it. Personally hurt by comments like this that would suggest that you were that insensitive. I know better. I know what you did at my father's service personally, Larry Gibson. I know what you did at my Uncle Kiefer's service personally. So I understand what you're talking about. I just think it's important. Are you concerned now also as a campaign person for Kweisi Mfume that the campaign is going to go in this direction, that it's going to be maybe ugliness like this?
I'm not a campaign person for anybody. I'm an advisor. I think of what Kweisi calls me, an advisor. All y'all use this advisor and mentor stuff. I don't know exactly. I think it means I'm old.
I wasn't going to go there, but you said it. You said it. I wasn't going there.
is that what that means? But be that as it may, I am responding to this just because I just want the record straight on this particular point. That did not happen, and it would not have happened. Well, it just did not happen, and that there was a discussion 10 days later, and it was for the purpose of hearing from her what she wanted to do. We did not know. Elijah never mentioned to me the possibility of Maya running to fill his seat. I mean, I would have expected he'd say, Larry, if anything happened to me, you know, Maya wants the seat and do what you can to help her. And that never happened. There are two other people. I think that I'm surprised that if he wanted her to run for a seat, he was mentioned. One is Vernon Sims. Vernon Sims was his chief of staff.
His main man.
For his entire career in Congress. I asked Vernon, did Elijah ever mention the prospect of Maya running to replace him? Vernon says no. And then finally, Harry Spikes. Harry Spikes was like a son to
him.
Harry just carried him from one place to the other. He never mentioned it to Harry. Now, of course, husbands and wives can have discussions that, you know, we don't know about. So that was the purpose of Kweisi contacting her pastor 10 days after the Elijah's death, setting up a meeting for the 11th day to hear what she wanted to do. That's the only meeting. That's the only contact. There was no within. This article says less than 36 hours after my husband passed that she was approached. That is not true. I mean, less than 36. I mean, that's 3 days. I mean, I assume, I mean, at that point, she's in funeral preparation or whatever. But this is not true. It's not something I would ever do. It did not happen.
Well, Professor Larry Gibson, I appreciate you clarifying the record, particularly with this Baltimore Sun story. And hopefully we can hear from former Congressman Kweisi Mfume and Mr. Spikes himself, because I don't believe this issue is going anywhere.